Years ago, a friend gave me 10 boxes like this, which turned out to be super handy for propping things up at various heights. So I decided to build some more boxes of different sizes. The weakness of these ones is around the top, so the new ones will have a frame around there. So I started with some pieces of 2x4 and squared them up on the jointer and planed them to the same thickness. I'm gonna join the pieces with 1/4-inch box joints using my box joint jig. Got the stock clamped in, this side marked as reference so I know this always goes against the fence for the next cut. And these two pieces of tape tell me where to start the cut. So when these line up and the crank is here, that's my home position. And then to hog out that slot, I make a cut here, make another cut here, and another cut here, and that makes a 1/4-inch slot. Finish that turn, and another turn, and that starts the next slot. I just cut all the joints in the short pieces and these all start with a gap. The long pieces have to start with a finger in that position, so I have to offset the jig, but that's easy enough because each turn of this gear is 1/4 turn, so I just start one turn offset. And that way these line up with the ones I've already cut. So that these line up and these line up. These pieces will be the rim of the box and I want a handle to grab in like that. Something like this, not going all the way through. And I've set up my pantry rotor to cut this. Here's the shape of the handle that the follower bearing can follow. And the router bit will cut that in the workpiece here. And the dust collection hood is really nice for this, but it means you don't get to see very much. And that's a bit of a hard edge to grab, so I'm gonna put a round over on it on the router table. Now I just have to build the rest of the box. But before that, I have to glue it together. I noticed just in time that something wasn't right. So the way I was going to put this together, I realized just in time I had the handle facing the inside, which means I had to flip this piece this way around. But that puts the glued side this side, and I don't want to leave that glue open like that. So I had to act quickly and glue that to another piece like that, and then grabbed another piece and glued that up. So now it's saved. And for the last piece, I have to glue up two joints at once, which is a little bit time critical. And with these tight box joints and lots of surfaces to glue up, it was already starting to get tight on me and I couldn't push it together by hand anymore, so I had to resort to clamps. And the last joint for the second box went the same way. I just needed those clamps. I cut those box joints to be proud a little bit. Now I gotta flush trim them. The rest of these boxes is just going to be made out of plywood attached here, just with a rabbet. Now when the plywood goes on the sides, that leaves this edge for things to get caught on in the box, so I'll chamfer that. After that, cutting up a whole lot of plywood scraps to make the sides and bottoms of the boxes. Got 4 short sides, 4 long sides, and 2 bottoms cut. Now for these boxes, if I'm standing on it like this, then the bottom pushes against the sides and is very strong. But If I stand on it like that, then this joint is not ideal in terms of taking a load. So for these boxes, I want to join the bottom with a very coarse sort of a box joint to address that. I better mark these so I know which ones go together. Now I just have to join the ends the same way. And finally, I have all the pieces that fit together. So these are some very sturdy boxes. Absolutely no racking even on the front. So these will be useful for propping things up to various heights whenever I need to.